Hi guys, this is my channel Azan Family, and today I'm making biryani for 8 people. So first I'll just heat my pan which I'm going to make biryani curry. Basically there is 2 steps. First we make chicken curry for biryani, and then we're gonna boil rice and then start layering the biryani. So first we'll just add cooking oil in a pan. It's about 4 tablespoons around. Now when the oil is hot, then I will put chopped onion into the oil. And I'm going to golden brown these onions. So it will take around 5 to 10 minutes depending on your stove heat. So I will meet you guys after 10 or 15 minutes. Okay, now once the onion is medium brown, now with the chicken, what I marinate the chicken overnight, what I put in the marination is salt, red pepper to taste, turmeric powder, coriander powder, nutmeg powder, some biryani essence, ginger garlic paste, yogurt, and grounded garam masala powder and oil. So these all things I put in this chicken and marinate it overnight, so the chicken is full of flavor. So now once the onions are brown, I'm just gonna add this marinated chicken into the golden brown onions. Let's not waste masala. I'm going to mix it well. Now in this point I'm going to put 2 medium sized tomatoes chopped and going to mix it well. In this stage, because my kids love potatoes in the biryani, so that's why I'm going to put in this point my square cut potatoes just like this size, and I soak in the cold water so it will not be black. So I'm going to drain off the all water and put potatoes with the chicken, so it will take all masala, all spices very nicely. Now I'm going to mix it well until the oil separate in this for 5 to 10 minutes. I'm going to mix it very well until the all tomatoes are tender now, and the oil is separated from all masalas I made. So it will take around 5 minutes. So we'll meet after 5 minutes. Okay, now once I've covered the my chicken curry with the lid, it has been 20 to 25 minutes. I cover it and let it cook and simmer. So now we can see the potatoes are done, and also my chicken are tender now. So now I'm going to stir this until I want the thick consistency of the curry, and for while that the curry is already ready for the biryani, so I open the lid and put the stove on high and let it cook that the oil all water evaporate. Okay, now I'm going to boil my rice. The boiling rice is the simple procedure. I'm going to heat water and then I will wait around 10 to 20 minutes until the water boils. Okay guys, while my water is boiling, and that for that time being I'm just going to make green raita, green yogurt, this sauce to spread on the biryani. It's called raita, it's green and it's very tasty. So for that I just need 1 teaspoon of cumin seed, 1 medium sized green chili, 4 to 5 small size garlic clove, 1 and a half handful of mint, and 1 and a half handful of coriander, just leaves. Okay, so I'm going to blend these ingredients in the magic bullet with some yogurt, and then I'm not putting salt at that moment because it's gonna be very watery now, so that's why I will add salt later on. So I'm going to blend these all ingredients in the magic bullet. Now these with the yogurt I blend it and it's ready, and then I'm going to add as much as yogurt I want, and the green chutney is ready now, and then I'm going to add yogurt as much as I want the raita. So second thing is that now I'll just see the water is boiled now for the rice, so I'm going to put some garam masala in the water so get the nice aroma. It's 1 bay leaf, 1/2 teaspoon of the cumin, 4 to 5 green cardamom, 4 to 5 or maybe a 6 black peppercorn, cloves, 4 to 5 clove, 1 big black elaichi, and 4 to 5 stick of cinnamon. And now these all going to be boiling with the water for 5 minutes. Now the water is ready for the rice. I have soaked around 5 teacup of rice. So I'm going to add this soaked rice in the boiling water. And I'm going to add 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 teaspoon of salt into the water, and then just mix gentle, and then let it cook until the rice boil. Okay, so now I drain my rice, and I'm going to put this tawa, the pan, on the stove, and I'm going to on my stove on medium. Now in the same pan which I use for boiling rice, I'm going to put first layer. We are now layering the biryani. So these are the boiled rice. I boiled the half of the rice, just half, in the first, and then this curry that we made earlier, I'm going to put this on top on the rice. I'm going to spread it around. And then another layer of the rice. This is the top layer. This is the top layer. I use Pakistani basmati rice. It's called Falak. And this, into this last layer, I'm going to spread this fried onions and these curry leaves, some two big green chilies, one handful of mint and coriander leaves, and last I'm going to put I have half cup of yogurt. Into this I'm going to use orange food color to give biryani nice color. It is just you can see it's a half teaspoon going into the half cup yogurt. I'm going to mix it in the yogurt and I'm going to spread it this color into my biryani on the top layer. And then the last thing I'm going to put is cooking oil, just like a 1 to 2 teaspoon, just to give nice glossy look to my biryani rice. And then I'm going to cover it, and it's, you can see there is a tawa on the stove, and then I'm going to put on the medium to low, and then it's going to be on the dum, which is say the on the low flame. I will let it cook for half an hour to 20 minutes, 15 first minutes into the medium heat, and then last 5 to 10 minutes on the low. So I'll meet you after 15 to 20 minutes. Okay, so now biryani is done, because we can see this steam is coming out from the rice, so it's ready to mix. I'm going to mix it in front of you. So just from the side, I'm going to mix it from all the sides. Just like that, from the down to up, mix it. So this is the biryani final look. We are going to serve with the green raita and the fresh salad. Hope you like this video. Please subscribe to my channel Azan Family, and like and comment below. Thanks.